Hello and welcome to another video. This is a video I've been wanting to make for a while. It relates to the fundamental concept of Git and branches and repositories and GitLab's role in all this. And it's triggered by the fact that we are doing merge requests, and that is also a strange and difficult concept. So we need to establish where we start. So we have some repository up here. So we call this repo, and we assume that this is, let's say, the master branch. Master branch. And what you do normally would be that you do a you do a Git clone, which means that you copy your the repository from the from somewhere and you put it down on your own local machine. And then when you're done, you will do a Git push. Let's add a commit down here just to be specific. Whenever you have made changes, you commit it, and when you have some commits and you have finalized the feature or whatever, you push it back to the repository. All this is fine, and let's add this one and say this is my namespace. This basically means that this is owned by me in this case, and you will need special permissions in order to be able to change stuff here. And down here, this is still my stuff. I'm still allowed to change stuff here. Okay, so let's add a couple of extra repositories. So this is yet another repository, and what if you fork it, then let's get back to forking in a moment. Then you have your own repository in and this would be your namespace. So it means that we copy the repository over into your own namespace, and then you can do exactly the same as I just did with my namespace in my namespace. And then we have the repository. Ah, let's do the same sizes. And then you do a Git clone to copy it to your machine. And then you do a Git push to push it to the repo. And we still have the concept of commits down here. So let's do a quick discussion of where we are up here. All of this is on GitLab.com. GitLab is a place where we save Git repositories. It's a way of managing your projects and so on. But from a Git point of view, it's a place you can put your Git repositories and get the concept and share data among different people. Down here, we have your laptop. And over here, we have my laptop. So you will notice that up here we have a shared space where we can access stuff ourselves. And down here we have my laptop. My laptop actually doesn't know anything about yours, and yours doesn't know anything about me. And currently your laptop doesn't know anything about my namespace and the repo I have there. So when we are forking things, we are copying stuff internally on GitLab.com. It's the same on GitHub. So we have the something internal copied. And then you can pull that down, do stuff to it, push it, do whatever you want. And then at some point you say, okay, I'm done. I want to push stuff back to the other namespace. But you really do not have permissions to do this. So what we do instead is that we do a merge request, which basically means to the owner of the repository over here, I have added some extra stuff that I think you should include. And then the owner of the repository over here can decide whether or not to include it. I want to add something here that, let's do it up in the corner. Merge request. It's a GitLab thing. And then we have the pull request, which is the GitHub thing. Same thing. So let's get back over here. So I have my, you have forked my repository and you don't have access to write. So you say to me, hey, I have made some changes I want you to include. Okay, fine. And then there's a merge request and I can decide to accept or not. That's always, that's fine. So we also have another thing that goes from the repo from GitLab.com to your laptop. And you do this by using git pull or git fetch. They have some differences, which is besides the point here. And we can write over here also. This is something that we can always do. Git pull, git fetch. So a git pull or fetch means that you pull whatever you have of new stuff in this repository down to this repository. And I can do the same over here. So we end often in a scenario where this repository is behind compared to that one, which means that when we send a merge request, it's actually not up to date enough for us to make a merge request. So we need to update this one. And the way to do it is to do this. So we must introduce into this repository that this one over here exists, bypassing this. So let's add yet another color here. So this repository here, from the point of view of my laptop, will be origin. This would be the default name. So when you do a git clone, it will just call it origin, lowercase, unless you specify something else. But what we could do is that we could do a git remote add and some more. And then we can actually specify that this repo knows this one up here. So what I usually do is I add this one up here as upstream. So doing this command, we will be able to add an extra repository, and then you can do the, so instead of doing git pull, we will suddenly do a, yes, this is a miss. You will do a git pull but you will do a git pull upstream master. So you have defined, so this repository down here will now know that it has an origin here and something called upstream here, so that he can just pull any updates from here down to this one. And then this one will be nice, and you will do your updates and then push it to your own repository and then make the merge request. There's another super important detail about Git repositories, and that is that repositories are all equals, which means that just like I can add that this repository down here knows of this one and this one, I can actually set it up so it pulls from over here, from the other laptop. And just as long as there are connectivity and, you know, IP resolves and such, you can just pull it from this repository if you like. You can have multiple repositories on your laptop. So it will just check if, and you can pull from here if that is what you want. This is just by convention among the programmers that this is the master repositories where everybody shares their code. In an open source world, this one changes from time to time. So it's a convention that says that this one over here is more important than this one or that one. So that's by convention. So whatever we have done with making knowledge about the different repositories, we can add as many as we like, provided they start from the same starting point. So in recap, we have a lot of stuff happening up in GitLab.com. You can fork projects in GitLab.com. When you do a Git clone, you copy it down to your own machine. You can do stuff to it and then you push it back. And the same goes for your forked. The repository you have on your own laptop doesn't know that it's forked. It simply only knows the GitLab.com thing in your namespace. And then you can push it to your GitLab. And then when you're done, you can do a merge request. If you need to update from the original repository, you need to do this git remote add something in order to get an upstream remote that you can use. This is an introduction to a lot of words, and there will be a lot of resources online that explains this in gory detail, but this is the conceptual overview, where you have your git pushes, you have your git clone, you have your git pulls, you have your git commits, and the concept of forks and merge requests. Forks and merge requests are not a git thing, it's a GitLab GitHub thing. Yes? So I hope this helps in understanding the differences, and thank you for listening.